Hey, welcome back to the Week in AI. I'm Kevin Cook, your field guide and storyteller for the fascinating arena of artificial intelligence. What a week. You know, last week, on Friday, we did our space. Myself and my colleague Ethan Feller at QuantSpec on X. And there was just so much to talk about. I mean, not only did you have conferences from NVIDIA and AMD, you had this little company called Apple do their worldwide developer conference, and Sam Altman writes a love letter. Zuck drops $15 billion. So much to talk about. So a couple notes here. This is, you can listen to the replay of the space that we did on Friday. Just go to my X feed and look for this. It was the Week in AI. I posted this. So we did it on June 13th. And even if you don't listen to the recording right away, it's 60 minutes. We go fast, more than 12 topics. You want to go through the comments because I put all the links to every resource and expert on X or outside of X that provided something that was, you know, part of the 12-course meal for the Week in AI is linked in there. And then also, if you're watching this on YouTube, go into the description and you'll find the link to the article version, because in the article version of the video you're watching now, I go into detail on sort of the top seven events, reveals, partnerships, innovations in the Week in AI. So let's dive in right now to some of the top things, because they'll show up in order, in the order that I posted them. The first would be NVIDIA GTC Paris. Jensen went to Europe and showed off new stuff, made his pitches. Here he is holding the new, what's it called? This is like a mini DGX for your desktop. Now the name escapes me, but it's such a cool little device. They revealed this at CES, and it's only $3,000, and it's a billion parameter instrument for, you know, you basically got a cloud on your desktop that can do AI for you. So, it's Spark, DGX Spark. So the reason he's holding that and showing it off is because he tells the story of how when he created the first DGX-1, it was, you know, it had 8 Volta GPUs. And a Volta GPU back in 2016 only had 21 billion transistors. Compare that to Blackwell now. Blackwell has 208 billion transistors. But Jensen tells the story of how when he launched DGX-1, which is pictured like a college dorm fridge about that size with 8 GPUs in it. He said nobody wanted it. Nobody cared. Nobody was interested, except this little startup out of San Francisco called OpenAI. And obviously, the rest is history. And when he found out they were a nonprofit, he basically had to give it to him. So the other big news last week was Apple writes a paper about the illusion of thinking. Well, there was a lot of blowback on that, so we go over that in the space. You can also find the links again. Just go to find this link to the space that I posted on June 13th. I've reposted it a couple times, and you'll find all these links. All right, so a lot of controversy. That's why I say there's basically a civil war in AI. We've gone from, like, think about healthcare. In healthcare, what are the two big things, the two big gauntlets you need to cross with the FDA? Safety and efficacy. Well, there's a raging debate about AI safety, but now is the debate about efficacy. Does it actually work? Is it doing real thinking, real reasoning, or is it an illusion? So there's been some rebuttals to Apple on that. Apple's kind of taken on the world there. All right, here's Ilya. He was an early OpenAI founder, basically saying the brain is a biological computer. I take him to task on this. This has been one of my rants that no, the brain is fundamentally different than silicon for reasons having to do with emotion and how we learn when we're young. So that was one of my rants. GTC Paris, let's see. This is a commercial real estate developer that I converse with on X, and she's convinced that AI will be able to do her job very shortly. Can probably do 60% of the, and she does complex deal underwriting for, you know, big commercial projects. So she sees the writing on the wall. So Sam Altman, his essay, his blog was titled The Gentle Singularity. Well, that was my big rant of the week, because I took the other side of Sam saying the singularity won't be gentle. It's going to cause so much job disruption that nobody really understands what's coming. And Joffrey Hinton agrees. Here he is talking. He says, ideally, we want a symbiosis where machines handle the mundane tasks and humans can live more interesting lives. But he says, that's not the kind of society we live in now. And so this sort of goes back to Yuval Noah Harari in 2016, his book Homo Deus, where he says, history shows that new transformational technology is almost always controlled by the rich and powerful at the expense of the common person. So Hinton is worried about that too. Oh, I asked ChatGPT, give me list 100 jobs that AI systems will replace in the next 3 years. And I share that link. So I didn't ask it to do heavy research, just list the job and a brief description. And so it's a starting point for conversations to, you know, whether you're an employee or a business owner or an entrepreneur of some kind, you want to be thinking about what gets replaced, what gets reinvented. Harper, I introduced her as a great new AI resource because she's a computer scientist and she explains the Apple paper. Here's Ben Mann, co-founder of Anthropic. He says, we'll know AI is transformative when it passes the economic Turing test. And to him, that's give an AI agent a job for a month and then let the hiring manager choose who did a better job. I think that's pretty powerful. All right. Speaking of jobs, which is a constant theme in the space we did, a new company called Mechanize. And it's misspelled here. It's just like you would think, mechanize. So here's the New York Times article, rather. This AI company wants to take your job. Mechanize, a San Francisco startup, is building artificial intelligence tools to automate white-collar jobs as fast as possible. So what this says to me is we think about job disruption, economic displacement. We think about it sort of happening organically, you know, bubbling to the surface, creating unpredictable change. But this company is like a mercenary. They're intentionally going after white-collar jobs that can be replaced by creating the system, software, and platforms that they can basically go into a company and say, okay, we can eliminate, you know, 50% of your headcount or more. So that's pretty interesting. Here's how many people work at Google, Microsoft, and Meta. Let's see. Oh, there was a little math meeting out on the West Coast recently at Berkeley, and even the mathematicians were surprised at what the LLMs were able to do. Jan LeCun taking on, giving some shade to Dario Amodei of Anthropic. Okay, so here's where my headline comes from in this article. I basically stole the quote from Mark Andreessen, very bright, on top of all this stuff, invests in all this stuff. You know, he was the guy in 2011 who said that software is eating the world. And now he knows that AI is eating software. He says, we're investing against the thesis that basically all incumbents are going to get nuked and everything is going to get rebuilt. In other words, investing against the thesis, like that's where they're putting their money, you know, leaning on that thesis that incumbents are going to get nuked, meaning every company has to reinvent. Pretty strong words. And this guy knows the stuff. He's connected to a lot of businesses from startups to the Mag 7. All right. Google offers buyouts. As always, in the links here that I put in the comments, I give you great people to follow. Daniel Newman is one of them. He runs a technology research group called Futurum. And he thinks, you know, Google will survive the transition from classical search to generative search. And just like, you know, their Gemini may become the first AGI. So I wish I'd known that before I sold my Google shares on the last search scare, but there you go. All right. How fast and how much cheaper are the LLMs getting? This is a good chart that explains that. Going back to Sam Altman saying that, oh, it's going to be a gentle singularity. Here's somebody who might disagree. Dave Shapiro, he writes about post-labor economics, what things look like. And, you know, if you could eliminate 25% of white-collar work, there is going to be a decoupling. All right. Probably the last thing I'll show you here, and then you can dive into the rest. I'm only showing you about half the links. Apple had their Worldwide Developer Conference, and Robert Scoble is the guy you want to follow for all things Apple. And a lot of things AI and AR, VR too. He's at Scobalizer. He gave his cynical take on WWDC and his dark take and his somewhat hopeful take. So that's if you're an Apple fan or investor, definitely follow him. In the article version, I put his full comments here on WWDC. But I'll share this real quick about what he's excited about. He's an early adopter of all this stuff. He got the Apple Vision Pro right away. And so he's looking forward to what Apple and Google do next with a wearable. And he says, we will judge them by who has the best AI inside. He said, that's more important than the resolution. He thinks Google is pulling away. He goes, I'll buy both of them anyway, because that's just how he is. So he's a great follow. Let me just see if there's anything. Zuckerberg throws down $15 billion for scale AI. I can show you, I asked Perplexity a little bit about this. Like, why did they spend so much? Well, one of the things they did, by only buying a 49% stake, they avoid some antitrust stuff. But so why Meta paid so much? They get access to high quality data. Remember, scale AI provides giant sets of labeled data. You know, an algorithm, an LLM cannot just take any raw data and turn it into knowledge and insights. You know, the data has to be usable, so it has to be cleaned up and prepped, and that's what scale AI does. Probably the biggest thing that Zuckerberg gets is he got strategic talent acquisition. He basically gets Alexander Wang. So people are joking that Sam Altman said, oh, you know, Zuck is going to go around and give $100 million bonuses. I think he's just referring to the pay package that Alexander Wang gets for, you know, continuing to run scale AI and work closely with Zuck, which is, you know, this is going to be interesting if it gets past antitrust, because Microsoft and let's see who else, and OpenAI are already customers of scale AI. So do they want Mark Zuckerberg, you know, owning almost half the company? It's going to be very interesting. So let's just see. I love going through this so that I have to see if there's anything awesome that I have to show you. Ethan and I, here's Ethan Feller at QuantSpec. We also talk about just the rapid pace of what's happening with AI video generation. It's just unreal. Oh, and then AMD had their conference their advancing AI was on Thursday, June 12th. Lots of great reveals there. The stock is popping now finally because she's getting respect for what she's rolling out that hyperscalers and enterprises and industry and science are going to use. Just like NVIDIA, it's a duopoly. There's only two players for these large scale, hyperscale GPU systems, and NVIDIA can't meet all the demand. So AMD is next in line. Let me show you my article version here. So here's the article is called "Weak in AI, All Incumbents Are Going to Get Nuked." There's so much to cover in AI, I might have to do the show twice a week. So here I go into detail and recap seven of the top highlights that Ethan and I talked about. Some that I just went over: the new civil war in AI, Alphabet buyouts, Mark Andreessen, Apple WWDC, Scoble on Apple, Zuck splashes the pot with $15 billion. And AMD unveils an AI super rack. Oh, and Sam Altman was on stage with Lisa Su at her event on Tuesday. So remember, if you're watching this on YouTube, check the description for a link to the article version where you will find a detailed rundown of the top seven events. This is the rough draft of the article you're looking at. And we will talk to you soon. Probably, well, join us this Friday if you can for the Week in AI. But watch last week's replay first. All right, Cooker out.